All right, everybody, today I'm going to be showing you a video I shot, it's been at least a year or two ago, but it's on how to build a foundry pattern for a cast iron angle plate. All right, everybody, welcome back to the old iron shop.
So, I guess I'll explain a little bit about what I'm going to do here. Don't tell anybody out there in the machining world, but I'm kind of a closet woodchuck. Actually, I was into woodworking before I got into metalworking, and my hobbies have just sort of evolved and blending together, because pattern making is really all about being a good woodworker. So we've got some planes here and handsaw, and I got power tools I could use, but it's 1 a.m. right now, so I'm pretty sure my wife and neighbors wouldn't appreciate that so much. Here's the material I think we're going to use. And I don't know, this one here is pretty beat up, scarred up, but maybe we can work with that. But this was just, scrap laying around the shop. And kind of drew up a little plan here. I got enough wood here. I kind of measured it. And I can make 2 5-inch wide pieces. There's some knots and stuff up here. Woodworkers in general hate knots, and absolutely especially in a pattern, because the wood will swell on the long grain this way, but the knot, of course, the long grain is going that way, so you're going to get some weird shape in your part just depending on as the humidity changes. So don't put knots in your parts, it make life a lot better. Anyway, it's going to be 5 inches wide. And 5 inches wide and 5 inches tall. We got some 3/4-inch wood here. See how much is left after we're done cleaning it up, but it should be more or less 3/4. And then I'm gonna put a single gusset in the middle of it. And I'm gonna do like a stop dado in here. That it'd be really easy to just use it on the table saw, a dado cutter, and just hog out a groove all the way through, but when you leave that opening in the top, well, you got to fill it with something. So put some kind of putty or Bondo or something like that in there, or you can try to make the wood fit in there, but then you run into that same distortion that happens, you're going to have long grain running two different ways. It'll hold together fine and everything like that, but there goes my razor. But anyway, like I said, maybe I'm just too particular. So that's the plan. And I measured this thing here. This board is not quite 6 inches wide, I think. Not quite 7. It's 5 3/4 inch wide. So I guess that's going to be, after it gets done machining and everything like that, it'll be more or less 5 by 6.5 or something like that. So anyway, let me set the camera up here and we'll cut this thing up. All right. Well, it's always a good idea to use a little bit of paraffin wax on the saw. Makes things cut a little bit easier. Let's see how this saw here behaves. I think there's an issue with this thing. I need to probably go through and sharpen it up again. I hope you can see the line, but I got a line right here, so I'm gonna, normally people will just drag it back, and that's really something you would do with like a big crosscut saw, an old carpenter's type saw, but this one here, that's not necessary. Cutting pretty good, actually. There we go. That's scrap. You can see the knots here. Pretty much got them all out, except there's a little bit right there. That's all right. We'll get that there in an upcoming step. All right. So this is a saw cut edge here. I'm gonna just clean it up a little bit here with my smoothing plane, because that just ain't good enough. actually pretty rough there. But it doesn't take much here, and we're sure not removing very much here. Well, miles by machinist standards probably, but one cut smooth, don't quite get it all. There. Nice full cut. Full width shavings are nice. Alright. So those ones there. Nice and flat. Lay close together there. Yeah, that'll work. Now, this one here is a lot taller than the other one, so in fact, it's a whole lot. So I'm going to use, just for kicks here, this is a scrub plane. And you see how big the opening on that is, and the blade's got a curve. This thing is, hand tool shop, you don't have power tools, but that thing really gets it done. You can see how thick that shaving is, and it could take a much bigger shaving if you really wanted to. This is heavy removal tool. That's just about got that all the same height, so now we'll go back to the smoothing plane. You can hear it skip. Not flat. Alright, that's got that. A little bit of throat rule on here just to make sure it's parallel. Let's see what we got here. What? That is spot on. Perfect. So we got these two faces parallel. Now what we need to do, I would really probably rather do this on the table saw, but no, we'll save, because I want to miter it. If I put a miter joint on here, then the seam will be right at the corner. And instead out here, and again, you get that weird distortion from humidity. If it was a piece of furniture, it wouldn't matter at all, but since we're trying to build a pattern, and honestly, really, even that it's a pattern, it probably still don't matter. Okay, so I've done a little bit of layout work on here, and you can see that I've got a rectangle here, and it stops up here about a half inch away from the end of that. And the way we're going to do this, I'm going to chop into this here with a chisel down here at the end and take out a little chip, and then we're going to use a saw. We're going to saw down these lines on both sides, and then probably we'll use the router plane here. This has got depth adjustment, so we'll cut down quarter inch, I guess, maybe it'd be about right. We'll need to sharpen that blade again. So hopefully, you guys can see what I'm doing here. I'm just putting this on the line here for right now. Actually, just a touch away from it. Okay. So, of course, because this has a bevel, as it drives into the wood, it pushes forward and crushes the fibers a little bit. So. As a general rule, you don't want to start right on your line. Usually your lighting is terrible. I'm sorry, I'm going to have to turn away from you for a second here. Okay, there's that one. Okay. And then this one here at the end. This ain't really critical, just cut it all. But what we want to do is get in there, and then we can a little bit of a chip. That way when we run our saw. saw down here. Got somewhere for it to terminate into. So what I'm doing right now, because I want this to be a really accurate cut, right? So I'm just cutting out a little notch here, right on the line. Then I can get my saw blade started in that little cut. So the blade don't go jump off on the line on me. Now I can use this as a marking tool to mark the bottom of my saw cut. Tendency for a lot of nostalgia about the way that work used to be done back in the old days. They worked at such high degrees and stuff, but that is not always true. I've seen examples in museums and stuff where the backs of chair legs and things like that were just cut out with a hatchet. The front looked really good and everything like that, but you know, nobody was looking at the back of the legs. So why spend all day sanding them? Stop dado. Okay, so off camera, what I've done here, I took this little stick here, and I cut a couple of pieces, and I planed a little wedge onto them, because I wanted these two to sort of stay, I want that dado to stay in line when I do some more cutting here. What we need to do, if you remember, this is going to be standing vertically here, one of these. What I need to do, and you'll see how this works later, but these edges on the side, I need to put draft on them. I kind of drew a little line here on this, so I didn't, hopefully I don't mess up when I cut it. Anyway, so it's daytime now, so I can run the power tools. Righty, we got the table saw set up here, it's plugged in. I've got the saw blade tilted that direction, I believe 3 degrees. And you know, usually about 1.5 degrees is all you need, but I want this part to come out really easy. Since this edge is probably gonna end up getting machined off anyway, it won't really matter that much. Okay, here we go. Alrighty, and we're in the home stretch now. Let's see how this fits up. Looks like it ought to work. Proportions look pretty good.
Alright guys, I hope you enjoyed that little episode of Building Foundry Patterns. There's more of them. They'll definitely be linked in the video. If you enjoy this kind of stuff, please click on the horizontal mill icon to subscribe. And I'll have plenty more coming. I've got just about 100 videos as of right now. So there's plenty to keep yourself entertained. All right, see you around.